Hey, what's up everybody? In today's video, I'm going to show you how to change out your cutting blade on a miter saw. We're replacing this old beat up one with a 10 inch 40 tooth Craftsman. And here's the Ryobi sliding miter saw that we're going to put on. And you can see here's my old blade. It's completely burned up, completely dull. Even if you try to cut a 2x4, it's going to start smoking. So we're going to get that replaced. So there's really only two tools that we're going to need. The first is this number 5 Allen key, and then a Phillips head screwdriver. I'm just using a drill in this video or impact gun. It's completely overkill. You're not gonna need that. A screwdriver's fine. So you can see here when you pull your guard back, we don't have access to the bolt until we remove this guy. And we're not gonna pull it out all the way. We're just gonna take our screwdriver and loosen it up just enough so that the guard will slide back. That little bit there is more than enough. And we'll just go ahead and pull this plastic guard back, and then the whole mechanism will slide back far enough out of the way. Just going to allow us access to the nut that's going to allow us to take this blade off. And I've got this thing unplugged, so definitely don't worry about me touching this. Make sure that yours is also. What you'll see here is the bolt that we're going to have to undo, and this is where we're going to use our number 5 Allen key. You could also use another tool, just using a simple socket. It's a 1/2 that fits this. So either option that you want to use is going to be completely fine, just as long as we can get it loose. And this bolt's a little bit different than most. Usually we're going lefty loosey, righty tighty, but in this instance we're going lefty tighty, righty loosey. So it's completely backwards to what we normally do, and this is because of the rotation of the saw. So what you do is just go ahead and hold the saw, and then we're going to turn it to the right just enough to break it loose. It didn't really take much, and then you can flip your key around and just go ahead and loosen it up a little bit more until you can get it out by hand. The bolt's not very long, so once you get it out, just go ahead and set it aside. You'll notice it's also got a plate here, like a retainer plate, and here's the layout of that. So the indention goes towards the saw in case you get that mixed up. So now our saw blade is free to be removed, and we just slide it right out. And there we go, that's our old blade. We can just put this aside. Maybe you can find out something to do with it. There's also another, I guess you call it like a washer here on this side, just like on the other one. And in case it falls out, here's the layout. You just put it right back into place, and it's going to sit there on that that bracket. And then we're going to bring out our new Craftsman 10 inch 40 tooth. And then make sure your blades are pointing the right way. They're going to kind of be pointing towards you in this case. And it just slips right back into place. And then we're going to go ahead and just reverse everything. So take your little plate here. It's got little lines on the side where it can only go on here one way, little flat spots. So just go ahead and push it into place, and it should hold while you put it aside to get your bolt. And then we're just gonna reverse everything. So now we're gonna go lefty tighty again, which is opposite of what we normally do. But just get everything tightened down. You don't really have to torque it, but you do wanna snug it down easily by hand there. Then grab the saw and then kind of give it another good snug. This would be easier to do with a socket. But I did mine with an Allen key, and it worked just fine. Now that our blade's attached, we just want to give it a spin, make sure that it's spinning freely, make sure there's nothing obstructing it. It looks like it's good to go. Now we want to pull our guard back down so we can get our screw set back into place. And you'll see here there's a tab here, and as long as it's right there in line with the screw, that's what you want. Again, you don't have to torque this down, just give it a good snug, and then you're good to go. Give it a test, make sure everything's moving like it's supposed to. When you pull it up, you can see everything's flowing. Give it a test pull on here, and everything is operating the way it should. So that's all you really have to do. Everything is functional. It's a very simple change out. I definitely recommend doing this once you notice any kind of issues with your cutting. If you're doing any special projects, you notice the splintering, things like that. I definitely let this one go way longer than I should have. But it's pretty cool. I've cut a bunch of crazy stuff with this. I've got this all in my old videos, so definitely feel free to check that out. But if you have any questions or comments about this video or have any suggestions for future videos, definitely leave those in the comments below. But either way, I really appreciate you guys tuning in. Thanks for your support, and I hope to see you next time. All right, peace.